I believe in miracles. Ladies and gentlemen, Christianity is a miracle. The birth of Jesus is a miracle. The resurrection of Jesus is a miracle. The forgiveness of sins is a miracle. To be born again is a miracle. So everything about Christianity is a miracle. The rapture of the church will be a miracle, because mortality shall put on immortality. I feel like I'm preaching good this morning. The totality of the Christian faith is enshrined in miracles. It's possible to be healed. It's possible to get a miracle now. It's possible if you can believe. So when is the miraculous? The miraculous is when you believe. When you believe. When you believe, the miraculous comes into operation. The miraculous kicks in. You know, look at me, everybody. Let me show you what happens. Excuse me. How many of you know that when you get to the hospital and maybe they give you sleeping tablets or something? Is it sleeping tablet they call it? No? Sleeping tablets. For layman's English. Sleeping tablets. Okay? Tablets that help you sleep where you can't sleep. Now, when you take the sleeping pills, it doesn't kick in instant. It takes some seconds, or for some people, even minutes. Okay? Then it kicks in. When the effect of the pill kicks in, your characteristics begin to change because it has kicked in, and ultimately it knocks you out. The moment you believe and you say, you receive. The moment you receive, within seconds it kicks in. Now you stay there until the full import of what kicks in overwhelms you. That's when you have it. But some of you, when it kicks in, you abort it. You abort it, because then suddenly you open your mouth and say, this disease is very stubborn. Very stubborn. So what you're simply said is that even what I said I receive cannot kick it out. And so many people have a lot of abortions, miracle abortions, careless talk. Now, what we are talking about, miracles and healings, that's not believing the gospel. It's different from faith for salvation. Because for miracles, whether you are saved or not, if you just believe that Jesus heals, you get healed. You don't have to be born again to be healed. You don't have to be a child of God to get a miracle. No, this is faith for healing, or faith for miracles, or faith for supernatural provisions. Please listen carefully. Faith for supernatural provisions. If you believe that your daughter will be healed, it's not if you believe that Jesus rose from the dead. If you believe that your daughter will be healed, Jesus said, all things are possible to him that believeth. In other words, when it comes to miracles, what is a miracle? A miracle is an easy word. A miracle in scripture means an actual work of power. An actual work of power. So when you see the word miracle and you see power, is the same in the Greek. Dunamis, dunamos. Power, miracles, is the same. Just the same thing. A miracle is an actual work of power. An actual work of power. It's often referred to as the supernatural. So the power of God, therefore, in demonstration, is what we call miracles. The power of God working in a situation. The power of God, Lakota Manga, when you carry the power of God and you put it on a situation, it starts working. The working of God's power in a situation or a circumstance is what results in a miracle. There can be no miracle without the engagement of God's power. It is the confine of God's power that generates miracles. Am I teaching good? And that power is at work in you right now. To know the exceeding greatness of his power, which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead, that power is inside the believer. The exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe, according to the working energio. There is a working of his mighty power in the believer. There's a working. even now as you are sitting here, that power is at work on your inside. Somebody say, the power of God is at work in me right now. Shout it very loud. The power of God is at work in me right now. Now speak, bypass your mind and let your spirit speak it very loud. The power of God is at work in me right now. Say, in my body, the power of God is at work. Now say, I direct that power to my circumstances. Circumstances, the power of God is at work in my circumstances right now. I'm a candidate for a miracle. I thought I would hear a powerful amen. The power that raised Christ from the dead, the power that defeated death and the grave, that same power is at work on the inside of the believer. Now, unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that is at work. Where? In us, there is a working of God's power on the inside of the believer. And the believer can operate in miracles at any time. At any time. So miracles are an operation of God's power. So one of the first things about miracles is it is not logical. Miracles are not logical. Once you are talking of miracles, suspend your thinking. They don't make sense. Miracles don't make sense. Say with me, everybody, a miracle is not logical. You know, historians doubt the story of the Exodus. They doubt that story. You know the story of the Exodus? Movement of the people out of Egypt to the promised land. The historians doubt that story because they can't explain how for 40 years people moved to the wilderness. No house, no food, no clothes. For 40 years. And we're talking about 3 million people. 3 million. We're not talking of 30 people. We're not talking about 100 persons. We're talking about 3 million people moving at once. Can you imagine? You know, few years ago, Uyo was 3 million people, right? Few years ago. So you can imagine everybody in this city moving out of town. No clothes, no food, nothing. And we survived 40 years. Historians can't explain that. That's why it's a miracle. Once it lacks logical explanation, it's a miracle. Am I communicating at all? Brother R.W. Schambach said, a wonder is something that makes you to wonder. A wonder is something that makes you to wonder. Because there's no explanation to a wonder. There's no explanation. Any miracle that can be explained is not a miracle. It must dumbfound your senses. It must render your senses stupid. It must stupefy your senses such that when they say, how did your eyes open? He said, one thing I know. Once I was blind. Now, somebody shout, I believe in miracles. Say it again, I believe in miracles. Ladies and gentlemen, Christianity is a miracle. The birth of Jesus is a miracle. The resurrection of Jesus is a miracle. The forgiveness of sins is a miracle. To be born again is a miracle. So everything about Christianity is a miracle. The rapture of the church will be a miracle because mortality shall put on immortality. I feel like I'm preaching good this morning. The totality of the Christian faith is enshrined in miracles. He says, so is everyone that is born of God. Kabada. You cannot tell where he's coming from. You cannot tell where he's going to. But you hear the sound. A believer is a sign and a wonder. I am my children that God has given to me. We are for signs and wonders. I thought somebody would shout, I'm a wonder to my world. We are for signs and wonders. Shakataba, Metolada. The born again man is not a normal man. I declare over you today, you cease to live an ordinary life. I say from this moment, you cease to live an ordinary life. From this moment, the miraculous will be a lifestyle for you. Somebody shout, I receive. I declare my life is covered with the miraculous. Please sit down. Give me a few minutes. I'll soon be done. Miracles don't make sense. A miracle doesn't make sense. You know, I tell doctor friends of mine, because doctors keep treating patients with logic. They do their research, they do their test, then they find something in nature that can solve something in nature. That's medical science. Medical science is a discovery of natural solutions for natural conditions. That's medical science. A discovery of natural solutions for natural conditions. So that's why in medical science, there's calculation, there's analysis, there's prognosis, Abi. Prognosis. There's prognosis, Abi. And what else? And diagnosis. Prognosis and diagnosis. It sounds like some tongue. That's why every time doctors talk, it's like tongues. Koloto kukuka, kalato koluba. But those tongues don't have interpretation. It's only interpreted in their world. Am I communicating at all? So because of the depth they have in studying sickness and disease, they stand at a point where medical doctors are the greatest unbelievers of miracles. Medical doctors. Sometimes it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a doctor to receive a miracle. Because when you are speaking to the condition, they are seeing the analysis, the clinical analysis. They are seeing how that it is not possible. They are seeing everything, how it has degenerated. They know the end point medically. That's why medical doctors sometimes, when a miracle happens and you ask them, what's going on there? They will say, he's getting better. He's getting better. They will never say, he is healed. They will say, he's getting better. He's getting better. Because they don't want to break a medical rule. He's getting better. He's not getting better, doc. He's healed. This man is healed. Glory to God. I'm teaching good this morning. Yet there is wisdom that is given to them, which is not of the devil. Don't get me wrong. Medical science is not of the devil. Medical science is of God. Anything that helps people to get better is of God. Satan has never helped anybody get better. He's a killer, a stealer, and a destroyer. Jesus never called physicians terrible. Or terrible people. In fact, Paul had an assistant or an associate who was a medical doctor. His name was Luke the physician. He wrote the book of Luke and the book of Acts. And those books are filled with miracle accounts. I'm talking about Luke the physician, brother Paul's companion. So a miracle is an actual display of power. An actual display of power. And is supernatural. And it's not the natural means of things happening. That is, when a miracle happens, it bypasses nature. It bypasses the natural process. It is supernatural. It is the actual display of God's power. So which means, When things are impossible in the natural, then there's the power of God to intervene. So the intervention of God in the course of nature is a miracle. The intervention of God in the course of nature is a miracle. Hallelujah. So when is it possible in the natural? When you believe, when you speak. Of course, in the natural, it doesn't make sense. A miracle is that which happens that is not logically explained. It is not logically explained, which means that when it is the miraculous, I am not logical. I am not trying to calculate or analyze what I am thinking. I am saying the power of God is working right now. I'm not thinking. Because at that time, my thinking is not required. Because a miracle is not a mind thing, it's a spirit thing. So it means that a miracle suspends the natural process. A miracle will always suspend the natural process. Is that instantaneous, spontaneous suspension of the natural course of things. Spontaneous, instantaneous suspension of the natural course of events. For example, there's a growth that you keep growing. Then it stops and never grows again. That's a miracle. Because naturally, it should keep growing. But there is an intervention that interrupted the process. And instead of growing, it shrinks. It shrinks. Tumors melt. And suddenly, lumps in the breast melt and disappear. That have the tendency to be cancerous. Yet, when the power of God moves into that part of the body, it interrupts the natural process. Everything that was fertilizing the growth is rendered impotent. That's a miracle. Limbs that were weak, that could not carry your body. So because they could not carry your body, a depreciation has happened to the limbs. Then the power of God moves into those limbs, suspends the weakness, restores the nerves, the tissues, the tendons, the muscles, and the limbs to strength. And then all of a sudden, a man that could not stand up stands up and he's able to stand. What happened? A miracle. An intervention of the super over the natural. And it's available to you now. We're not talking about a future thing. Your eyes that were diminishing, that you could hardly see. The power of God moves in there. And hey, the power is not coming from heaven. The power is not coming from heaven. The power is already inside you. We just took off that power by speaking. We redirected that power to the eyes. And the moment the power entered the eyes, it suspended nature. And suddenly, the eyes can see. Am I teaching here? That's a miracle. That's a miracle. In the natural, impossible. In the spiritual, possible. Please pay attention. Someone is due for surgery, and she comes with an appointment. The question I will ask is, what do you believe for? I will never tell you not to go for surgery. And I will never tell you to go. What do you believe for? She says, I don't believe in the surgery. I agree with you. So she goes home. No surgery. Not because I told her, but because she took a position with the word of God. And I supported her position with my faith. So I and her are in faith that the surgery is over. And from that moment, we redirect God's power to suspend nature and cause what will have created the need for surgery to be rendered impotent. That's a miracle. That's a miracle. That's a miracle. Somebody is supposed to be fired in his office, and we redirect God's power to that office, and the power of God moves into that office and shakes the organization. The power enters the office and shakes that organization, and in the midst of shaking, things shifted. Then suddenly the office realizes they cannot sack you, because after this sudden shakings that have happened, your office, your position here has become too relevant. We cannot send you away. That's a miracle. Am I teaching? That's a miracle. And it's available to the believer. The report of the doctor is not evil, but that's just a natural course of things. You need a miracle because the natural course of things is unpredictable and unreliable. You know, sometimes they operate somebody and the problem comes back. There are people that have been operated from the same condition 2-3 times, and they are not even sure they will not need another operation. But with God's power, and you know, the natural is too cumbersome. For them to operate you, they have to make sure you are physically fit. If you are not, they put you on a diet. Then when you are physically fit, they now open you up. For hours, they cut you, blood and all kinds of things are tampered with. You are suspended from everything you are doing. Then the doctors eventually package you back together. You have to go through a recovery process. And what they did is not guaranteed. And sometimes, mistakenly, they could cover a scissors inside. So they have to open it again and remove the scissors. You remember the lab in Nigeria that saw cockroach in somebody's chest? Then he went to India for operation. When they did the lab test in India, they discovered that the cockroach was in the X-ray machine. You're not hearing. The cockroach was not inside the chest. The cockroach was inside the X-ray machine. So when the X-ray was taking place, because of where the cockroach was positioned, it reflected in the heart of the person. So they told him, you have a cockroach in your heart. We can't operate it here. You must go to India. He flies to India. Look at flight ticket. Look at hotel bills. He may have sold his house or sold his land to go to India. Having arrived India, for the professionals to do their job, they don't trust your X-ray report, so they have to confirm in their own report no cockroach. Then as they check the X-ray you brought from Nigeria, they discovered that the cockroaches were so skillful in operation that they found a comfortable place to stay in your machine without your machine detecting them. So when it has to do with the natural, there are so many things that are limited. But when it has to do with the supernatural, when the power of God moves, which is already inside you, am I talking to somebody here? The moment the power of God moves on the situation, it suspends nature and it does a perfect job. No operation, no money required, no cutting of the body, no endangering the life, nothing. It just happens instant and spontaneous. God is a good God. God is a good God. He knew that after the fall of man, the body of man will be subject to mortality. So disease and all kinds of elemental conditions will affect the body. So he made available his power. And let me tell you what the power of God does. The power of God is creative. So if an organ of your body has been damaged, when the power of God moves into operation, it can recreate that organ. where the doctor say woman has no womb, when God's power moves into her body, it creates a womb. Suddenly she's pregnant and she has a child. They say the man does not have sperm, or his sperm is low. The power of God moves into his sperm system, and suddenly he is pregnanting his wife with triplets. What's happened? The course of nature is suspended. I believe in miracles. Oh, you know, I have seen too many miracles in my life. In my own life as Abel Damina, I have seen miracles in, not the one I prayed for people, in my own personal life. I have experienced miracles upon miracles. It is too late for anybody to tell me that the day of miracles are over. It is too late. I'm not talking about headaches. I'm talking about diseases that had the ability to terminate life. Diseases that could take away life. Where doctors already looked at me and shook their head. You know, when doctors look at you and do their head, it's over. It's over. And I'm not talking about doctors I don't know. These are even doctors that were part of my ministry. They looked at me. Two of them, husband and wife, medical doctors. They looked at me and shook their head. The wife started weeping because they loved me. The wife wept and walked out. The husband looked at me and said, "We'll be back to check." But with them, medically, it was over. When they left, and I knew that now I have to make up my mind whether to go or to stay, I remembered the gospel that I owe the world. I took my Bible and walked my way through the scriptures. I began to see accounts of miracles. I read and read. I was just seeing account of miracles. The reality of the miraculous overshadowed my mind. I stood up and I said, in the name of Jesus, right now I receive a miracle. That night was the end. By the next day, I broke out in sweat. I stood up and did what I couldn't do for days. 2 days after, I was preaching in another city. That was the end of that disease. I've seen too many miracles in my life. I've seen too many miracles in my life. Too many. Too many miracles. Jezebel, my second daughter, in her mother's womb, the doctor right here in Akwa Ibom on a Sunday morning looked at my wife and said, "You are carrying a dead child. The child is dead." The doctor checked, the midwives checked, everybody checked and said, "The child is not alive. We have to evacuate the pregnancy." Mama said, "You have to wait for my husband." I was preaching that Sunday morning. I finished preaching and I got to the hospital. Mama said to me, "The doctor said the child is not alive. They want to evacuate." I said, "No, you can't carry a dead child for 9 months in my house. You can't carry a dead child for 9 months in my house. No, it's not possible. It's not possible." I said to her, "Where is the doctor? Let me talk to him." And I went to that doctor. Dr. Etina, you know, Etina, one hospital there, Ubonga Basi, I hear he's going to be with Jesus. I went to him. I said, "Doc, don't touch," according to Ghanaians, "don't touch that baby." He said, "Why?" I said, "My wife can't carry a dead child." He said, "But medically we have examined." I said, "No. Go again and check." He said, "No, the last thing we can do now is a scan." I said, "So what stops it?" He said, "Well, it will cost you a little money." I said, "I'm ready to pay." "It's okay, it will be tomorrow morning." I said, "No problem. Tomorrow morning, go do it. Then when you do it, let me know." I told Mama, "Relax. You will deliver this baby. Relax. Relax. You remember now? Relax. You will deliver this baby." The next morning, early in the morning, they took her to go and scan. They scanned and came back. Mama sent for me. I got to the hospital. The doctor, as soon as I entered his office, stood up and said, "I'm sorry, sir. My apologies." I said, "You better be sorry." He said, "That baby is alive." I said, "I told you." "I told you. Not in my house. I know that a miracle took place between that afternoon and the following morning. A miracle took place. A miracle took place. You make up your mind whether you want to accept the condition or you want to unleash God's power to suspend nature and create a miracle. You make up your mind. The choice is yours. There are two ways you can go about it. You can go about it naturally and you can go about it supernaturally. And this is not just for body healing. This is not just for sicknesses. Even for circumstances, conditions, your job, your work, your businesses, your career. Miracles are available because God's power does not have a limitation. God's power operates anywhere and everywhere. Am I talking to somebody here? All it takes is for you to believe it. And when you believe it, you say it, you receive it, you have it. I thought somebody would shout hallelujah. God's power is creative. God's power is restorative. And God's power is curative. Are you following? God's power is preservative. It is creative. Where a creative miracle is needed, the power of God, the same power will create. It is curative. Where a cure is needed, the same power will cure. It is restorative. Where your leg has been chopped off or your hand has been chopped off, short hands can grow, short legs can grow, missing womb can grow. Underdeveloped organs in your body can develop. There's no limit to the operation of God's power. I believe in miracles. I believe in miracles. I've seen the dead raised. 2 days dead, brought back to life. I've seen too many miracles in my life to ever look at a situation and say it's impossible. I've seen too many miracles. I've seen too many. In different realms of life. I've seen the preservative power of God. When all kinds of things break loose to attack your life and God preserves you. God puts kabayota. The power of God just creates a canopy around you. A canopy. And the power of God just physically stays there like a pillar. Things are coming, but they are not able to get the effect. You see them boom, 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 boom from everywhere. You're just standing. And after everything, as if nothing happened, you continue life. It's the preservative power of God. Am I talking to somebody here? Somebody say, that power is in me. That power is at work in me right now. Is at work and miracles are already happening right now all over this place, online, on television, on radio. Miracles are already happening right now in this service. Miracles are already happening right now. I didn't hear that amen like thunder. Stand on your feet. Let me pray a miracle prayer for you this morning. Say with me, I believe in miracles. I'm a candidate for a miracle right now. I receive miracles right now. I didn't hear a powerful amen. Lift up your two hands. I want to pray. If you're watching online, I want to pray. On television, on radio, I want to pray. Miracles are going to happen instantly. We're going to have instant miracles right now all over this place. Now, as you lift up your hand, just before I pray, if there's a condition in your body you need a miracle for, place your hand on that condition. If it's a growth, touch the growth and begin to just, you know, begin to press on that growth. If it is a leg condition, put your hand on that leg. If it's a knee, put your hand on that knee. If it's a waist, touch the waist. If it's your eyes, put your hand on your eyes. If it's in your, you know, whatever part of your body, just place your hand on that part of your body. And if it's the totality of your body, you don't even know where it is happening, put your two hands on your head. Matola koroto sakela. And I want to have your amens like thunder as I pray right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I speak to every natural limitation, every disease, sickness. I come against barrenness, deafness, dumbness. I rebuke eye conditions. In the name of Jesus, I come against disease in the body. Heart disease, liver disease, kidney disease. In the name of Jesus, Satan, get your hands off. Every oppression of the devil, be broken, be broken, be broken. In the name of Jesus. Matala batananga. Negrato shakata. Brede sokula nanga. Egereto sika ladaba. I rebuke ulcers, high blood pressure, sugar, diabetes, out in the name of Jesus. Where you need a creative miracle, I speak the creative power of God into that area of your body. Receive a creative miracle. Receive a restorative miracle. Receive a curative miracle in the name of Jesus. Those of you in need of business miracles, career miracles, miracles for jobs, employment, whatever area of your circumstances you require a miracle, we release the power of God in that situation right now. Receive a miracle. Receive, 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 receive. In the name of Jesus. Tumors are disappearing. Growths are melting. Fibroids melting. Lumps melting out. Pain, go, go. Pain, go. Discomfort, go. Deaf ears, open, open. Sight restored. Sight restored. Sight restored. Jakota, Melika, Zapota, Mabara. Low sperm count restored, healed and restored. Shakota, medalota sikia. Every problem with your limbs, with your ankles, every problem with your kidneys, your liver, restored in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. All over this place. All over this place. All over this place. The power of God is moving all over this house. The power of God is moving all over this place. All over this place. That's it. That's it. The anointing. That's the anointing. That's the anointing of God. That's the power that raised Christ from the dead. That's that power. It's moving all over the house, moving all over the internet, moving all over television, moving all over radio. That's God's power. It's moving all over. Nekora, Takola, Jekola, 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 Nekro dosokala da baba. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Agaboshakia. Father, we give you praise. Lift your hands and begin to praise him. Begin to bless him. Begin to bless him. Begin to bless him. Begin to bless him. Your name is a miracle. Your name is a comforter. Your name a mighty God, Jesus. Your name, your name is a miracle. Your name is a
Check that side of your ear. If there was a growth in your body, check your body right now. Miracles are happening all over this place. I'd like you to do what you couldn't do before. We're going to shout and celebrate. If you couldn't run, run. If you couldn't jump, jump. If you couldn't scream, scream. Go ahead and let's celebrate. Give the Lord a shout all over this place. Give him a shout, give him a shout, give him a shout, give him a shout. Glory! In this house, do what you couldn't do before. Wherever you're hearing the sound of my voice, men are arranged. Men and systems are arranged. Situations have been arranged right now to work in your favor. The delay is canceled. The delay is suspended. In the name of Jesus, receive, receive. Good news. Miracle phone calls, miracle emails. That check is signed. Those your papers for citizenship have been approved. They have been approved. They have been approved. That job you tendered for has been approved. That money you've been waiting for has just been signed. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name. I didn't hear your amen. Amen. Say it three times very loud. I believe in miracles.
I believe in miracles.
Two.
I believe in miracles.
Three.
I believe in miracles.
Can I have a powerful amen?
Amen.